Well, I came down today intending to speak, wanting to speak, desiring to speak, needing to speak, glad to speak. Because the people of 31st District want me to speak. They want me to let you know what they're thinking. And the majority of the people of the 31st District don't like this budget. They don't like the fact that the two-thirds majority was taken away. They don't like the fact that businesses are going to be taxed and jobs are going to be lost. They don't like the fact that we are closing a bit of Rainier School, although it's still there, and for that I am very grateful. We fought hard for that. I want to mention just a few things. The Department of Revenue is now, because of this budget, going to be allowed to pursue uncollected taxes from terminated or insolvent limited liability corporations. What does that mean? It means that if you happen to be a chief executive officer of a company, you are going to be personally liable for the failings of the company. If it goes under, they're going to come after your home, your car, anything that you have put together for your family over a lifetime. This is a huge, major step that will curb any kind of new person coming into the business field who wants to try to move forward. This is a major change in the way we'll be operating businesses. It's not going to be good for business in the state of Washington. I wanted to talk a little bit about the bullion issue here in this budget. Right now, drive down the road and turn on the radio when you hear people coming in and say, we want to sell you something stable. We want to sell you gold. We want to sell you bullion. And call this number and we're going to let you do it. And because this budget's going to pass, you're going to need to call that phone number or go online, because there aren't going to be any bullion or coin dealers here in Washington State. They have a very, very small margin, 2 to 5%. These businesses are going to have to close because people will be able to call the phone number rather than go down to their local bullion dealer. Just another small niche that has been caught up in this that is going to cost jobs. This is a tax bill. This is a job loss bill. It's a sad bill. I've gotten so many phone calls from so many people. They continue to come in. They're not supporting this tax budget. They're not supporting the loss of jobs that it will bring. So with that, I urge that we vote no on this tax bill, and that we've got to respect the wishes of the people. And I'm here today to at least urge you to do that by voting no.